Evening students, today we are going to discuss about the fifth unit of low power VLSI design, that is leakage power minimization. Okay, that means we have to observe, we have to reduce the leakage power. Clear? Coming back to the introduction, as the technology is going to be increased day by day, okay, the device scaling in the VLSI techniques are also improved from millimeter to nanometer era by providing increasingly higher performances. Okay, performances improvement has been continuously achieved because of the gradual decrease of gate capacitances. Okay, that means without sacrificing the performance, we are increasing the technology from millimeter era to nanometer era. That performances primarily, I am not talking about that is the only reason, I am saying that primarily the performance improvement has been continuously achieved because of the gradual decrease of gate capacitance. Is it clear? Nowadays, if you observe that so many devices are going to be operate with 5 volts, okay. Now, because of the technology improvement with device size scaling, the operating supply is also going to be reduced from 5 volts to 3.5 volts and 2.5 volts with respect to the device size scaling. Is it clear? Then if you observe that, what happens if the supply voltage has been reduced with the device size scaling? Is there any happen? Means if you observe that, okay, if you reduce the supply voltage with respect to the device size scaling, if you observe that the threshold voltage and the delay, the threshold voltage and delay, if you observe from this graph, it is exponentially, okay, increasing. Then if you observe the subthreshold leakage current, that means if you observe the subthreshold leakage current with respect to the threshold voltage, it is decreasing. That means what I am trying to say here is, if you reduce the supply voltage, then definitely there is a change in the threshold voltage. The change in the threshold voltage, that means the, if you increase the threshold voltage, what happens to the delay time? Means it is rapidly increasing. That means if you increase the threshold voltage, higher threshold voltage, then the subthreshold leakage current is going to be reduced. That means if you observe here, if the threshold voltage has high values, then I am going to say that the subthreshold leakage current has been reduced. Here if you observe clearly, there is a low power dissipation. If you observe that for low threshold voltage there is a less delay, then I can able to say that high performance. That means what I am trying to say here is, for high threshold voltage values we are getting low power dissipation, for less threshold voltage values we are getting high performance. The main idea is, what happens if we club these two in a single IC? That means it is not possible to fabricate with the help of multiple threshold voltage. Yes, it is possible to design an IC with the help of multiple threshold voltage. That is the next topic of us. That means fabrication of multiple threshold voltage. That means what I am trying to say here is, just now we have seen from the two graphs, okay, it is possible to design the various threshold voltages in a single IC. Yes, it is possible. Yes, it is possible to fabricate multiple threshold voltages in a single IC. That means by considering the high threshold voltage transistors to reduce the leakage current and low threshold voltage transistor to achieve high performance, just now we have seen that. That's why before we are going to discuss in detail that, okay, we will see that what are the techniques we are going to use to implement this. That means, that is a topic, fabrication techniques used for implementing multiple threshold voltages in a single chip. If you observe clearly that these are the techniques we are going to use for this purpose: multiple channel doping, multiple oxide CMOS, multiple channel length and multiple body bias. Is it okay? Yeah.